from the Democratic Republic of Congo. Does anyone know where that is? Yeah. One thing I realized, every time I say to someone, I'm from Congo, every Nigerian comes, oh, are we no Lumumba? But yes, I am, and I'm a very proud Congolese, very proud Congolese. I left Congo at the age of 8, moved to London. Well, I say moved like it was my choice. My parents took me to London. And I remember very early on, you just knew you didn't belong. A lot of ignorance happened when I was growing up, which made me a very strong African very early. I had my friends Tom. Tom was very British, very English. Tom would come up to me and say, so Edmund, I heard you're African. I said, yes, I am African. He said, well, can you speak African? I said, what does that mean? So we'll speak some African. I said, I'm not going to speak a cocktail of languages. What are you talking about? Well, Africa is a country, so you must be able to speak Africa. I said, stupid fool. I had to educate him. I said, no, there's different parts of Africa. There's different countries. You have West, you have East, you have South, you have North. He goes, tell me more. I said, for example, you might have the Ghanaians in West Africa. See, Ghanaians are very, very different. Ghanaians are the type of people who, do we have any Ghanaians here? Yeah. Only one. Let's talk about them. Aggression at all. They are very calm people. They don't like war. You can tell from the way a Ghanaian speaks. A Ghanaian will be so romantic with his words. So we are going to Lagos, Nigeria, to the Julius Agun show. Oh my God, we are going to have a wonderful time. The first time I went to Ghana, the way they welcome me at the airport, I didn't know I had so many A's on my surname. Oh my God, Mr. Cardi, you are so welcome. You are going to have a wonderful time. That was just the men. You should have seen the women. You should have seen. But then he said to me, well, what's that got to do with anything? I said, well, because maybe if you go to Nigeria, the Nigerians are also different. See, he said, what do you mean? I said, well, Nigerians, for example, I had to use the example of dance. Because different parts of Africa dance differently. A Nigerian would dance as if their life depended on it. But Nigerians dance with no smile. Full anger. You can go to a Nigerian wedding. You think that man should be happy that his daughter has gotten married? No. From the dance, he's confused. Chairman, give me something Nigerian. Give me something Nigerian. Find something Nigerian. From the way he does, you can. It's different. You
by the way, they're best friend.
They dance totally different. East Africans, you can tell from the way they dance that they're very united people. They can see trouble from afar, just from the way they dance. You can't fool an East African. Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania. You can't, from the way they dance, they will see trouble from afar. An East African can catch a plane from the dance. Chairman, give me something, anything you want. Don't panic, just press the triangle.
Confused.
A South African will dance as if he just landed at the airport in Lagos and he is lost. He's not sure where to go. He gets frustrated. Chairman, give me something. Give me something. A communist man will woo you. Chama, when you're ready. Don't embarrass me. one thing is for sure, Eddie. Sometimes I'm afraid to go to an African house. I said, why? And he brought down a very interesting story. We had a friend called Tunde. At the time we were about 14. He said, every time I go to Tunde's house, I feel like something is wrong. I said, what's wrong? I said, well, it feels like the dad speaks a lot in the house. But the mom, it's like she has no rights, Eddie. She doesn't say much. She just makes these silly sound effects. So what are you talking about? Say, what is it? What's all that about? So I thought, well, let's go and ask Tunde. So we went to Tunde. Said, Tunde, what's wrong at home? Is mom all right? She doesn't seem to say much. Is everything okay? You can tell us, we're friends. Tunde, being a Nigerian, was already offended from the beginning. Already offended. What are you trying to say about your mom? I said, no, listen. We just want to know why your mom only makes these sound effects. Tunde looked at me and said, you two are both stupid. Especially you, Eddie, as an African, I'm ashamed of you. Say what I said, do you not know African women are the proudest? An African woman does not need to say much to express her feelings. So what does that mean? Go, when you hear, it's an expression. When you hear, it's an expression. I said, what are you talking about? He said, is when you're mad. Is when you're confused. Is when you've had enough. When you receive the deportation letter. I said, so what's your point? He goes, is when you get it. Is when you are in love. Is when you receive your British passport. This is exactly what happened in the house. Now, I'm going to need you guys to help me with this one. On this side, your side is Can you give me after three? One, two, three. Wonderful. This side, you are the side. So give me after three. One, two, three. And this side. This side. Fantastic. So I will be Tunde's dad, you are Tunde's mom. When I give the mic to your side, assist me with this. So this is what happened. That I came into the house, kicked the door down. Bah! Sweetie, you know I love you. I will always love you. I'm here to support my family. I'm a hardworking man, but I've been sacked from my job. Don't be afraid, I have some savings. But you must start working. Why are you so lazy? You know you need a second job. Why did I even marry you? Sweetie, I'm joking. You are the love of my life. I will never let you down. Today, borrow me 20 pounds. That was the conversation that happened. That's the day I understood. Don't mess with an African woman.